Hi everyone, this is Kayla from the Berea College Forestry Outreach Center. Today, we'll be using rabbits as an example for talking about adaptations. We won't be able to talk too in-depth about them, so I hope that after this video, you will research on your own, online, reading books, or asking friends or family. This is my pet rabbit, Jude. He is about 8 years old, so he's a bit of an old man rabbit. Jude is a domestic rabbit, which means he doesn't look like the wild ones we have here, which are eastern cottontails. But even though he doesn't look like them, he has the same behaviors and diet as the wild rabbits. So we can watch him to learn about the wild rabbits that we may see. So like I said, Jude is already 8 years old, which is a bit old for rabbits. They only live about 10 years, and that's when they are kept domestically, which means humans are taking care of them. What do you know about a rabbit's diet? A diet is what an animal eats. Pause the video and think about or write down some things you think a rabbit would eat. Hop around on the ground and eat all sorts of greens and leafy plants that grow out of the ground. One of Jude's favorite is clover. They'll also eat bark off of certain types of trees and twigs. They'll eat hay and different types of fruits and vegetables. But the most important thing to notice here is that rabbits only eat plants. This means that rabbits are herbivorous. That means they only eat plants. Animals that only eat meat are carnivorous, and animals that eat both meat and plants are omnivorous, and that's what we would be. Now, as you see Jude eating, he uses his front teeth, called incisors, to pull the plants out of the ground, and then he'll use his back teeth to grind up the plants so he can swallow them. So his front teeth are his incisors. They grow throughout their life. So when they eat materials and bark that they nibble on, it grinds down their teeth. And if they didn't grow continuously, their teeth would grind down too soon and they wouldn't be able to eat. Because their teeth grow back, they constantly have a new surface that helps them eat. So the way a rabbit's teeth grow and function is an example of an adaptation. An adaptation is a trait that has developed in a species over time to make them more likely to survive. Adaptations can be physical traits as well as behavioral traits. So their teeth is not the only adaptation that rabbits have developed over time. Take a minute and think about other body parts on the rabbits, or even behaviors that rabbits have that are an adaptation to help it survive. One adaptation that I find interesting and cute is that female rabbits give birth 3 to 4 times a year, and every time they have babies, they have 3 to 8. The mother nurses them, and the babies are ready to go off on their own after only a month. Growing up quickly means that the baby rabbits are more likely to survive, and having more rabbits in general means that the population will grow. As you've probably noticed in the videos of Jude, rabbits don't walk, but they hop. Eastern cottontails can hop up to 18 miles an hour. They have big back feet that they use to push off the ground and propel them forward. Not only that, if something is chasing them, They move in a zigzag pattern. So they hop back and forth side to side while they're moving forward, so it's harder for the prey to catch them. Their speed and the way that they run in the zigzag pattern are both adaptations that the rabbits have formed that helps them survive. One last adaptation I wanted to point out is their ears. Why do you think they're so big? Do you see how they move around? I want you to research. What is special about rabbits' ears? What if humans had ears like that? What would we be able to do? There are a lot of other things that make Eastern cottontail rabbits super interesting, along with being cute. I hope after this video, you're interested and you'd want to read more and research on your own about Eastern cottontail rabbits. And the next time you see one, maybe you'll have a better appreciation for how cool they are. Thanks for spending time with me today. If there's anything you want to learn about, leave it in the comments below or message us on Facebook. From the Forestry Outreach team, we hope you stay safe and have a great day.